Hey guys, it's me, Arlene, Delicious Delights. Welcome to my channel. All right, so in today's video, I'll be doing some unboxing fragrances of perfumes that I bought when I was away in Canada. So I did do some shopping while I was away. I did buy quite a few things, some blind buys, some not. So I guess in the coming time, month or so, you can expect some unboxing videos from me because I personally really enjoy doing that. It's quite exciting for me, to be honest. And I hope you guys enjoy watching the unboxing videos. So yeah, I won't do all of them in one video. I'll kind of just like spread it out. But first, I'll show you what we have here. Few boxes of some fragrances that I picked up. Now let's begin with the first one, and I actually already unboxed this one on my own because I don't know why I did that. Maybe I just was a little bit too eager, but this is actually a backup travel spray that I picked up, and it's a fragrance that is one of my most favorite gourmand perfumes of all time. So I picked up another little travel spray of Flor Aiku, One Umbrella for Two. This I have raved about since like 2018, you guys. I enjoy this one so much. I actually brought my other travel spray of this to Canada and I wore it there. Really, really enjoyed it. And I saw this, it was on sale, so I decided to grab another one so that maybe I'll leave this one here and then I'll have the other travel spray in Canada. So let's just open this up here. Oh, by the way, it came with a few samples and one of them was this one, Initio Rehab. Initio Parfums Privés Rehab Extrait de Parfum. I have heard of this scent, but I haven't tried it. I'm not that familiar with the house of Initio. I think I only tried Side Effect and I can't remember much about it right now. It was like a tobacco or some kind of boozy scent, something like that. But anyways, I'll probably do a first impressions video on this at some point. But then I'll quickly show you what this one looks like. You've seen it before if you've been watching me for a while. Has the logo there, some kind of paper insert with all of the bottles. And then it comes in a little pouch like this. And then we have a nice little 10 mil little travel spray of One Umbrella for Two. So this one smells literally to me like a warm blueberry muffin. And imagine yourself in a kitchen where there is a batch of blueberry muffins in the oven. All of the windows and doors are closed to this in this house, and so all of that concentrated blueberry muffin bready goodness is trapped in the house. And then you open the oven door and all of those smells come out, and that's what this one smells like to me. This is a black currant scent, but to me it smells like blueberry muffins. And also there's tea in here as well, and it does remind me of like a blueberry tea with milk. And then just eating that on a relaxing Sunday afternoon. Very comforting, cozy, photorealistic, yummy, delicious, and definitely recommended if you are looking for a blueberry muffin scent, because this is definitely the one to try, and I love it so much. And yeah, I don't have a bottle of it. I think I'll be okay with the travel sprays of it because it is a quite pricey scent, and you know, I have enough fragrances. I can probably, you know, use this up for a long time because I don't wear it every day. So that's One Umbrella for Two from the House of Flor Aiku. Now let's get into this one here. In this box is one of my favorite designer women's releases. of 2021. I liked it when I first tried it, and then I tested it more and more and more, and then I liked it more and more to the point where I said to myself, you know, if I like it that much, I might as well get a bottle of it. So it's in here. Let me just open this up here. I'll do it off camera. It's quite a large box, so just bear with me for a sec. Well, maybe I should. It's an unboxing. I'll show you some. So there's some of these bubble wrap things, and they gave a ton of freebies in here, which is awesome. I love when companies give freebies. It gives me more of an incentive to buy, of course, but then of course I always go back to them. If they have some cool freebies, I'll buy from them again versus some company that only gives one or two samples or no samples at all. I'd rather go to the place that gives freebies. So here it is. I'll just go through quickly the freebies that it came with. It came with a Clarins Hawaii. What is this? It's a bag. It's a bag. So let me just open this up here. A tote bag. Very tropical. Ah, okay. So yeah, it's cute. Look at that. Super cute little tote bag to put stuff in. There are the handles. Quite thick, a nice thick material, and I like that. That's just super cute. You could put food in it for a picnic or something, or I don't know, go to the beach. Yeah, so that was a really nice little freebie. And they were so kind that they actually sent two of them. So I'll be giving this one away. I don't need two of them. They also gave a nice little pouch here. Shiseido Wasso. Yeah, it's just like a pouch makeup bag thing here. Let's see. Oh, that's really cute. Look at that. The pull tab is like a lemon. So there you go. One, I don't know what that means. 1.5. I don't really know what that means. 1.5 times a water bottle. And then a pouch, like that's kind of weird. But the interior is really nice with all of the lemons. I like that. I can put like samples in there. And some samples that they also included. I actually ordered this one separately. I did have to pay for this one, but this is Zirshoff K-Bridge Club Eau de Parfum. I don't know why I bought this. I think it's because of the name. It sounded interesting. K-Bridge. I think it's Knightsbridge, if I'm incorrect. I don't know. Could be mistaken, but I don't know anything about the scent, but I am curious about it, mostly because of the name. It did interest me. They gave a sample, which just flew out of it here, of Black Opium Eau de Parfum Extreme. And also a sample of a new release from the House of Chloé. It's Chloé Eau de Parfum Naturel Rose Bio Organic Rose. So hopefully I can do a first impressions or review on that sometime. Another freebie that they included, and this is the one thing that convinced me to buy it even more, is a little travel spray here of Black Opium Eau de Parfum Extreme, 10 mils. I just love freebies so much, you guys. And that's what it looks like. I can take this with me, of course, when I'm traveling or just in my bag. Very nice, convenient size. I just love travel sizes because they're the perfect amount. You know, this was a freebie, but I would probably buy this separately. And the perfume that I picked up, if you haven't already guessed, is Black Opium EDP Extreme. So I have reviewed this one before. I can link that down there if you guys are interested in seeing that. But let's open this one up and sniff it again. It's been a while since I tested this scent. And this is my one and only Black Opium perfume. I do like Black Opium Neon very much. But yeah, this one I just felt, I don't know, was just growing on me so fast after I first tested it and reviewed it that I just really enjoyed this one. So let me just open this up here. This is what it looks like. Same bottle as the other ones, but this has a nice little sparkly, I don't know how to call it. It looks kind of metallic. It has a nice texture on it. A glittery silver thing. But yeah, this is a really nice scent if I can get it open. Oh my goodness, how do I even open this? Oh, that's, yeah, the cap is pretty hard to get off. Anyways, so Black Opium EDP Extreme. Basically, it's a lovely dark roast coffee bean scent that isn't very sweet. There is some sweetness, but it's not overly sweet. Kind of smoky, like a burnt coffee bean. And I really enjoy this one a lot, especially for this coming season, fall, winter. I think this would be perfect. So that's what I picked up, you guys. My favorite, or maybe not my favorite, one of my favorite Black Opium flankers. I do like this one more than the original Black Opium, but I think this would be tied with Black Opium Neon for my favorite. I don't really know which one I like more. But yeah, this is a really nice, not too sweet, bitter, dark roast coffee with some smokiness and a little bit of sweetness. Yeah, so that's that. And the last thing I picked up was a blind buy. Let me just move this over here. And the only reason why I picked this up, it's right here. The only reason why I picked this up is because it was on sale. Hopefully it's good. I don't know, you know, blind buys are fun sometimes. And let's just get into this one here. All right, so let me just... I don't know why that didn't open very well. Bear with me with you guys. Bear with me with you guys. I'm a little tongue-tied today. Okay. Now, it came with some samples, so let me just go through that really quickly. Okay, so it came with a, what is this, classic shampoo and conditioner sample of Arawa. It says Arawa. So I haven't tried this brand before, so that would be nice to try out. And they also gave some other samples here. Aesop Primrose Facial Cleansing Mask. All right, probably won't use that. And we have another Initio Rehab, which is nice. So got two of those. Now the perfume that I picked up, completely blind, is from the House of Creed. And it's one that is marketed for men, but you know, I think pretty much everything is unisex. And it's Creed Royal Water. This is a 50 ml bottle. I remember trying this years and years ago. I honestly don't remember anything about it. So yeah, let's get this open here. There's the card. And let's give this one a first sniff. Okay, so here's what the bottle looks like. I'm pretty sure you guys are all familiar with this bottle design. I don't talk about Creed very often on my channel, but I'll say that my favorite Creeds are Virginal and Water, that's the first one, easily. I really like Millesime Imperial too. I really love Silver Mountain Water as well. I love White Amber from that other collection in the different bottles. What else is there? Arulfa is really nice. Aventus, I guess. But now we have Royal Water. So let's try this one here for the very first time in a long time. Wow, that spray is just massive. Ooh. Okay, so what I'm smelling here in the top notes is a clean, crisp, fresh breath of air. I'm standing on like a mountaintop. It's actually reminding me of Silver Mountain Water, where I'm standing on a mountaintop and there's like snow-capped mountains all over me and it's snowing outside, but there's some sun as well and it's kind of melting the snow a little bit. And then you take a big, deep breath of fresh air in, and then you get this cooling, crisp, kind of citrusy, minerally, kind of aquatic, metallic, slightly metallic scent. Yeah, that's what I'm getting from here so far. So it has some citrus notes in here. For me right now, it's lemony. I don't know what the notes are. Also, a clean spice, or like an herbally type of spice, and a saltiness reminding me of melted snow or like a sea breeze kind of aquatic smell. It's lovely. Yeah, it has this nice transparent kind of scent in here as well. Wow. Very, very nice. It smells very expensive. It smells bougie. Something that I would spray on if I'm going to like a place where I need to be more dressed up. It reminds me a little bit of Acqua di Parma, Colonia, I think it's called. It has that same kind of feeling. So yeah, that's nice. I'm happy with this blind buy. Very nice. Very, very nice. So I'm very excited to try this on my skin to see how it works. But yeah, this is a lovely scent. One that I don't hear much about, but I think it's lovely so far. So that's Royal Water from the House of Creed. And yeah, that's it for the unboxings for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you've tried any of these scents, I'd love to hear your opinion on them. And also stay tuned for more videos like this where I unbox stuff that I bought when I was away. And yeah, that's it for me today. So thank you guys so much for tuning in, and I'll see you guys soon in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.